Hello and welcome back to the channel. So in this lecture, we are going to talk about the second service model of cloud computing, which is platform as a service, also known as PaaS. So in the previous lecture, we have seen all about the infrastructure as a service. So let's talk about the PaaS in this lecture. So without further ado, let's get into it. So the platform as a service offers the runtime environment for our applications. So it also offers development and deployment tools required for developing our own applications. So PaaS has a feature of point and click tools that enables non-developers to create web applications. So it is more convenient than the IaaS. So the app engine of Google is a very great example of PaaS offering vendors. So developer may log on to these websites and use the built-in API to create the web-based applications. But the disadvantage of using PaaS is the developer locks in with the particular vendor. So for example, an application written in Python against the API of Google and using the app engine of Google is likely to work only in that environment. So now let's talk about the characteristic of PaaS. So here I have given the four main characteristics of platform as a service model. So the first one is PaaS offers browser-based development environment. So it allows the developer for creating database and edit the application code either via the application programming interface or the point and click tools, which is very convenient, and non-developers will also perform this activity. The second one is PaaS will provide the built-in security, scalability and the web service interface, which is a great advantage. The next one is PaaS provides built-in tools for defining workflows, approval processes and the business rules. And it is also easy to integrate PaaS with other applications on the same platform. And the last one is PaaS also provides web services interface that allows us to connect applications outside of the platform. So this figure will show you how the PaaS will be differentiating with the other service models such as IaaS, SSL and on-premise software. So in the PaaS, you have to manage applications and data, and all other things will be managed by your cloud vendors such as runtime, middleware OS, virtualization, server, storage and networking. All this thing will be managed by your cloud vendors and you will have the full control only on the applications and the data. So now let's talk about the benefits of PaaS. The first one is lower administrative overhead. So the customer need not to bother about the administration because it is responsibility of the cloud provider. The next one is lower total cost of ownership. So as customer need not to purchase expensive hardware, server, power and data storage, as the cloud vendors will provide those services to you. The next one is scalable solutions. So it is very easy to scale the resources up or down automatically based on your requirement, which makes it very cost effective. And the last one is more current system software. So it is the responsibility of cloud provider for maintaining the software version and the patch installation. So it is very to keep your operating systems and softwares refreshed to the latest updates. But it also has some drawbacks, like the SSAS, PaaS also places significant burdens on the customer's browsers for maintaining reliable and secure connection to the provider system. So therefore, PaaS shares many of the issues of SSAS. However, there are some specific issues which are associated to PaaS that I have given here. The first one is lack of portability between PaaS clouds. So, although standard languages are used, yet the implementations of platform services may vary. So, for example, a file, queue or a hash table interface of one platform may differ from one another, so making it very difficult to transfer the workloads from one platform to the other. The next one is event-based processor scheduling. So, the PaaS applications are only event oriented, which possess a resource constraint on the applications. That is, they have to answer a request in given interval of time. And the last one is security engineering of PaaS applications. So since the PaaS applications are dependent on network, they must be explicitly use cryptograph and manage the security exposures. So these were all the three main drawbacks of PaaS. So the last topic is PaaS types. So based on the functions, PaaS can be classified into the four main types that I have given in this diagram here. So the first one is standalone development environment. So the standalone PaaS works as an independent entity for some specific function. So it does not include licensing or technical dependencies on specific SaaS applications. The next one is application delivery only environment. So the application delivery PaaS includes on-demand scaling and application security as per the task that you are performing on the services. The next one is open platform as a service. So the open PaaS will offer the open source software that helps PaaS providers to run the applications. And the last type is add-on development facilities. So the add-on PaaS will allow us to customize the existing SaaS platform. So these were all the four major types of PaaS. So for more information, we will be covering all these topics in detail in our further lectures. So stay tuned and keep learning. So in this lecture, we have seen what is a platform as a service and how it differentiates as compared to the other service models such as SaaS, IaaS and the on-premise system. We have also seen the benefits, drawbacks as well as the characteristic of PaaS in details. And at the last, we have just seen the introductory part of the four major types of PaaS. So that's it for today. I hope you like this lecture. So please subscribe to our channel and also ring the notification bell to get the latest updates. And don't forget to follow us on our social media that I have linked in the description below. Thanks for watching.